Alright folks, now then, in this video what we're going to be doing is looking at beat matching, beat mixing, but more importantly we're going to be concentrating now on the bass line. Now then, this particular video is from a scale of 1 to 10, I suppose 1 or 0 being the easiest form of tutorials and 10 being the most difficult. This is probably 5 to 6 because we're getting slightly more intricate here. What we're going to be doing is we're going to be mixing in a bass line from one song into another song. We're going to be only having the bass line of this guy here, and we're going to be taking away the bass line from this guy over here and putting them both together as he knocks the camera. So theoretically what we should have is almost an entire song, but if you look at bass, mid and treble on both of these, okay? Now we have bass, mid, treble on this side, bass, mid, treble on the other side. What I'm going to be doing, I'm going to be taking away for a lot of the time the mid and the top on this side, so we're left with just the bass or bass line. And then the opposite on this side, I'm going to be leaving the mid and top, but I'm going to be taking away the bass. Now then, first of all, I'm going to play you this track here. Have a listen. Let's wang it forward a little bit, and I'll plug it in, the audio into the camera so you get better sound as well. So if we go a bit forward again, hold on. Right, that. Listen, the bass line. You can just about hear the bass line, alright? Then what we're going to be doing, there it is. But it's... That's the bass line. Right, what we're going to do, we're going to knock it into this track here. Okay? Right, let's just fold it a little bit. Now then, if I take the bass line away from here, that's all we're left with, okay? Knock it forward a bit more. Take the bass line away, and we're left with that. Now then, in a video I did just before this one, I showed you, the beginners, how to learn, or when I seek to beat match, how to mix, a good way of practicing, and that is just mixing using the beats. But then if you want to start, let's say, mixing halfway through a song, this is where it gets a bit more difficult, because then you've got a lot more to think about. You've not only got the beat, but you've got the bass line, melody, vocals, all that sort of stuff. And if you start getting lots of clashes, then it sounds awful, right? So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to plug this in here, and I'm going to have a bit of a mess around. I'm going to pan the camera closer to the mixer, so hopefully you can see what I'm doing. I do apologise if the beats go off a little bit. I'm not going to have headphones on. I'm going to mess around just a tad, all right? So we'll plug it in, and let's see what happens.
Live. stop, come on. Breathe, don't stop, come on.
Hopefully, if you get the general idea there, let's say you're halfway through a particular song and you can hear the bass line is not dissimilar to the other bass line, then you can mess around with the bass, alright? Now, logically, again, if you're talking about melody, you can mess around with the melody. The highs, you know, you can always mess around with those anyway. It doesn't really matter so much about the highs, but the main integral parts of your bass, mid and treble is the bass and the mid, because the bass will only really work on the beat and the bass line. The mid will only work on the mid, as in the vocals, the guitar, all the instruments, okay? So again, like I said, slightly more intricate here. If you want to start mixing one record into the other halfway through, you must remember, very important, the melody, the bass line plays a very, very big part in this. Hope it's been a help. Another tutorial for you. Practice and enjoy.